Good morning. It's Tuesday, November 17th, 2020. I'm Russell, and this is Rocky Road Devotions, a few minutes of help for today's journey. Our devotion today is entitled, Waiting for the Prince. In our scriptures, Philippians chapter 3. But we are citizens of heaven, where the Lord Jesus Christ lives, and we are eagerly waiting for him to return as our Savior. The little chapel sits just off the road on Highway 62 in Trinity. We've been living in Thomasville for 20 years and traveled that road a zillion times. My bride maintains she's never seen it before, but that chapel is older than we are. It got me to thinking about two stories. The first has no author but many writers. The second has an author but no other writer. The first story appears in many movies of the darker, mysterious sort, where a distraught, somewhat rumpled older woman is sitting at a bar, decked out in her fanciest evening gown, which is somewhat tattered. Her hair is straggly, and she's covered with her entire jewelry box contents, mostly costume, gaudy stuff. She's quite drunk and crying. She's also always willing to spin her tale of woe to anyone willing to listen. She's waiting for her prince who will come and marry her. He's tall and handsome, a dream of a man. She's been waiting 40 years. He never shows up. It's a sad story, and the writers never have to finish it. We know how that ends. Sad, alone, broken. The other story is of another fiancé waiting. Her prince isn't the Hollywood type. In fact, the last time she saw him, he was so disfigured she could hardly believe it was her man. He'd been beaten with fists until his face was so bloodied and swollen, crowned with a thorned wreath, scourged with a cat of nine tails, and finally nailed to crossbeams between two thieves on the town garbage dump. This was her bridegroom. To those uninitiated to the backstory, it seems a little like the two stories have the same ending. Disappointed bride, broken and lost. To those more familiar with a historically accurate story with no earthly author, this isn't a story. It's a promise written in blood. This bride will not be disappointed. The only ones disappointed will be those who do not prepare for the coming of the Lord, the church's bridegroom. Matthew chapter 25. Jesus says, Then the kingdom of heaven will be like 10 bridesmaids who took their lamps and went to meet the bridegroom. 5 of them were foolish and 5 were wise. The 5 who were foolish didn't take enough olive oil for their lamps, but the other 5 were wise enough to take along extra oil. When the bridegroom was delayed, they all became drowsy and fell asleep. At midnight, they were roused by the shout, Look, the bridegroom is coming. Come out and meet him. All the bridesmaids got up and prepared their lamps. Then the 5 foolish ones asked the others, Please give us some of your oil because our lamps are going out. But the others replied, We don't have enough for all of us. Go to a shop and buy some for yourselves. But while they were gone to buy oil, the bridegroom came. Then those who were ready went in with him to the marriage feast, and the door was locked. Later, when the other 5 bridesmaids returned, they stood outside calling, Lord, Lord, open the door for us. But he called back, Believe me, I don't know you. So you too must keep watch, for you do not know the day or hour of my return. For you today. That little chapel on Highway 62 is a picture of the waiting. It's a quaint and quiet setting with nothing special happening there, except that there's a notebook which many visitors have signed, leaving behind thanks for the quiet assurance of a chapel in the middle of nowhere. Some leave a prayer request for help and healing. To spend a few moments there reading the hearts of travelers' longings is like listening in on the whispered prayers at altars. It's holy. In the quieted hush of that log chapel, broken occasionally by a passing car or truck, there's an anxiousness to the waiting, but nonetheless a peace in the middle of anxious days. It is patience. The church today is a little bedraggled and lonely at times. Her costume jewelry, the robes, and all the fanfare of rituals and rule books don't do her destiny much justice. We look a little absurd and distorted, like her beaten and crucified bridegroom. But there's coming that day when she will see her bridegroom coming with clouds and glory. Best to be prepared as you're waiting for the prince. You chew on that as you hit the rocky road. Have a blessed day.